welcome to the Academy of Arts and Minds Charter High School First Commencement Celebration, Class of 2008. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem, presented by Stephanie Segaro.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land and of the free and the home of the brave?
Now, would you join me in providing a very warm welcome for our keynote speaker, Commissioner Joe M. Sanchez.
Good afternoon. How's everyone doing? Congratulations to Class 208. First of all, let me just say that it is truly a pleasure to be here as we make history. You are the first class to graduate from the Academy of Arts and Minds Charter High School. Give yourself a round of applause. The first thing that I want you to do this evening is to the students, of course, is for you please to stand up. Please, stand up. I want you to give your parents a big round of applause. I want you to remain standing and also give your teachers a big round of applause. Now you may sit down. Well, once again, I want to start by thanking the administration for allowing me this great honor to address you in this special event for you and for your loved ones. As you begin the journey through life, and let me just say you have not started life yet, but this is a great accomplishment for you. I can tell you that you could have not gotten here to where you're at today if it was not for the love and dedication and loving from your entire family and from the education system that we provide. And we already given them a round of applause. But let me just say something that I always say when I address graduating classes. There is no doubt in my mind that when you were born, being the great gift that you are in this life to your parents and to this world, each and every one of you is born with a gift. And if you're lucky, you may be born with more than one gift. It is up to you to find that gift and polish it like a diamond and turn that gift to goodness. You have done that today, and now you embark yourself to college or university, wherever you may go, and you will have many more opportunities. Opportunities will knock the door. You will have an opportunity to open up that door and decide what you want to do. I know that this is a school that focuses on arts, and let me tell you, what would the world be without music? What would this world be without theater? What would this world be without minds? And you have those minds. You have the potential to do anything you want to do in your life. And I know that you will succeed in that. Don't let anyone tell you you cannot do what you want to do with your life. For whatever you do in your life, just promise yourself that you will be the best that you will be. And you will not go wrong. I've been a city commissioner for 10 years, and I've dealt with a great deal of individuals. The one thought that I've always stood on my mind the most is those individuals who come to the table with innovative and fresh ideas. It is up to you, the future of this great nation of ours, and we are truly blessed to live in this great country. You possess greatness. Take that greatness, and you'll come in the life, the path of life, you'll come to the crossroads in life. Take the path of rightness. Don't let anyone down. Don't let your parents who have struggled to work two or three jobs, who have never turned their backs on you, and make them proud. So whether it's art, music, whatever you want to do, pursue it. Don't give up. Reach for the stars. I always say reach for the moon, because if you fall short, you're going to land on a star. So as I stand here today and I address you, you're looking at me and saying, well, what has he done? Well, let me tell you. Maybe some years ago, I graduated. I'll tell you the year, 1983, I graduated. And I graduated in 83, and you know what? Some of you may not even decide right now what you're going to do with your life. You just got out of high school. You're probably going to go to university, college, join the armed forces, take a summer off, take a semester off, take a couple of I don't want you to take a couple of years off. I want you to continue your education. But you know, you never know what you're going to do. But ladies and gentlemen, don't waste your time. You have that momentum going. Don't waste it. Study. You know, the greatest accomplishment that I could receive or your teachers can receive is maybe 10 years from now, when maybe I'm over at Sunset Place and I happen to run into one of you and you say, yeah, I remember you. You were a commissioner once, and you came and you gave a commencement speech at my graduation. You know, I'm an attorney. I'm a doctor. You know, I play the violin for whatever you do. But make sure that you're proud of what you do, because I know I'm going to be proud when I run into you and I see that you have taken the path of rightness. And that's the one thing that's very important for all of us here today as you celebrate. The important thing is that all of you have this with you, and it is starting today. Today, your life starts. I know that you will start to make a difference and be successful in whatever you do. The Academy of Arts and Minds graduation class of 2008 is something that you should be very proud of, because you've made history today. But the most important thing is that history will continue to make when you're able to be good citizens, loving citizens, people that care for others and make a difference in this world. Thank you once again for allowing me to be here today. Give yourself a round of applause. And I can only say, felicidades a los padres, felicidades a todos, muchísimas gracias, Dios me los bendiga. Thank you so much, God bless you.
Thank you again, Mr. Commissioner, for those inspiring words. And now for our first class member address from our valedictorian, Jessica Perez and Stephanie Segarra. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm sorry I lost my voice, so Stephanie Tomas will help me in saying it. Thank you.
We have all been waiting for this day, and it has finally arrived. We are moving on to a new chapter in life. Although it is frightening, it's very exciting. Because of the education we have received at A&M, we are ready for this new step in life. When I first arrived at A&M, I was not the straight-A student that I am now. School was not my first priority. I remember walking into Mr. Tamargo's class and feeling different about school. I was most interested and eager to learn. It was incredible. I went from being an average student to an overachiever. And for this, I thank the teachers and staff at A&M. The advanced level of classes I received at Academy of Arts and Minds have prepared me for the harsh but exuberating reality of college, and I am grateful for that. So I would like to say thank you to everyone at A&M, from the teachers to the students, and especially the administration. Thank you.
Our second class member address is presented by Estefania Pessoa.
Thank you, Camila, and good afternoon. My name is Estefania Pessoa, and I am one of A&M's mighty seniors. The memories I have at A&M aren't terribly cliche. Yes, there are detentions, tardy passes, and groundings, but the Academy of Arts and Minds was just so different from anything else. We all knew each other, knew everything about each other, and it's weird to think that I won't be seeing 3138 Commodore Plaza every day. My high school experience of A&M consisted of pasta, sore toes, and high fives with Mr. Tamargo. My high school experience included laughter, moments of frustration, and getting caught sleeping in Spanish class. Sorry, Ms. Rosa. Sure, there are times when I just wanted to doodle over every math test, to walk out of every ballet class, but dreaming of this day never let me. I don't remember anyone telling me, you can't do this or you can't accomplish this. I just remember a lot of turn off the phone. I will always remember Mr. Greenberg telling me to go join the circus if this college thing doesn't work out, or Mr. Lobar letting me eat his lunch when my mom forgot to give me $3. I know my mom will never forget waking up in the middle of the night to find me baking away for countless bake sales, or to be on the phone with Jessica trying to finish one of Million's assignments. I'll never look at New York City the same. I love my dancers, and I miss sleeping on the subway, as scary as that sounds. Mr. V always tried to run me over with his yellow bicycle, and I'll never forget Mrs. Fernandez's pearls and her stories from Parsons. There's not one thing I won't miss about A&M. I can't really say I'll look back on Miss Million's essays with fondness, or the insomnia caused by the stress of failing another one of Mr. Cohen's tests. I have learned that physics, although very interesting, is not my forte. I have also learned that I have each and every one of you to thank for helping me become the person I am today. Every fight, every sleepover, every waking moment at A&M has made me someone I'm proud of being, and I couldn't say that a few years ago. I never thought I would even graduate high school at one point, and I would just be a forgotten face in some yearbook. And here I am in this robe before you. People ask me all the time what I want to be when I grow up, and well, I want to be fearless like Miss Fernandez, young at heart like Leah, Miss Stevens, and Mr. V. I want to be determined like Mr. Tamargo and witty like Leonie. I want to be strong like Miss Million and confident like Mr. Cohen, as forgiving as Miss Marcos and as calm as Mr. Greenberg. You all have become a part of me, and I especially want to thank my mom for believing in me, especially when my SAT scores weren't so great. Out of all the memories of my high school career, none compared to the now, looking at all of us and knowing we're all destined for great things. Because of you all, I've learned it's not what you have in your life, but who. Saying goodbye is just the start of this new chapter in our lives. In the words of Helen Keller, life is either an adventure or nothing. Be daring, take risks, close your eyes and jump, but overall, remember that the people in this room will love you forever, no matter how many times you fall from grace. Always remember grad night, every field day, every last formal. Remember every time you flip through your yearbook, that when you see those eager faces, remember that together we make up the great class of 2008. Thank you.
Thank you, Stefania. Now we'd like to present Daniel Rodriguez.
I think getting out of these benches was more of a mission than graduating. Well, hello and good afternoon, everybody. My name is Daniel Rodriguez. I have been fortunate enough to be a student at A&M for 4 years. Let me tell you, it has been one roller coaster that was great. My 4 years have started off from 9th to 12th grade, and the 9th grade year was the best 9th grade year I can ever possibly imagine. It was 5 classrooms with 7 teachers. It was a year that Mr. Tamargo was our English teacher and made us read books like The Great Gatsby and The Old Man and the Sea. Mr. Tamargo, I will never be able to look at a marlin the same way ever again. Ninth grade was also a year that our greatest achievement was to go on the end of the year field trip. I mean, come on. Getting on a bus going 10 hours front and back from Miami to Orlando is great. It's great. Also, ninth grade was the year that we gave ourselves the greatest friendship ever. 10th grade came along, and we had field day, we had physical education with Ms. Stevens. Yay. Nothing like sweating and hyperventilating to get my day started. Well, after 10th grade passed, 11th grade came along with new activities, like more drama productions, more dance shows, more art galas from Ms. Fernandez. But it seemed too little. Then 12th grade came along and we had prom, grad night, homecoming. And to me, my greatest memory is of all, grad night. I mean, Magic Kingdom, my place of worship. It's the greatest experience I could ever ask for. But it wasn't all fun and games. I had to sit down in the office, long hours, with Miss Leonie Martin. And let me tell you, it wasn't easy. The Kit Kat eating, beauty glowing Miss Leonie Martin was a toughie. But at the end of every day, I would always learn something new. She would always teach me a new lesson. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart from what you've given me these last 4 years. And you will always have a special place in my heart for those finger-pointing lectures. And you will never lose your NS qualities. No. Well, before I leave, I want to leave you with a little quote from my role model, Mr. Walter Elias Disney. Somehow, I can't believe there are any heights that can't be scaled by a man or woman who knows the secret of making dreams come true. This special secret, it seems to me, can be summarized in 4 C's. They are curiosity, confidence, courage, and the greatest of these C's is creativity. When you believe in a thing, believe in it all the way, unquestionably. Get a good idea and stick with it, dog it, and work at it until it is done and done right. Fantasy and reality often overlap. Once this is realized, all your dreams can come true as long as you have the courage to pursue them. Imagination is your greatest tool and ally. My classmates, I've been with you for 4 years. I've learned so much and I've done so much with you. Today, I look at you, you're wearing the white gown sitting on the bench, and I don't see friends, students, classmates. Today, I see a family. Today, we are the family of 2008. And from one family member to another, I want to give you an advice. No matter what happens in your life, whether good or bad, never give in to your fears. Any obstacle can be overcome. There's never a mountain too high, nor a dream too difficult to achieve. Anything is possible when you have imagination and love deep within your hearts. And most importantly of all, whatever happens, whatever life throws at you, or what you think you can do, always, forevermore, you must keep moving forward. Every time. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Daniel. Now, for the A&M Senior Chorus performing our class song, Remember Me This Way.
Okay, so we practiced. This is why I've been the way I've been for 4 years. Okay. Alejandra Enriquez, she'll be graduating summa cum laude. She'll receiving 75% Bright Future Scholarship. Will be attending the University of Miami and studying microbiology and immunology. Travis McLaughlin will be graduating summa cum laude, superintendent's diploma of distinction, 100% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending St. John's University and will be studying pre-med. Jessica Perez will be graduating summa cum laude, superintendent's diploma of distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Florida International University with an accounting major. Stephanie Tomas, will be graduating summa cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, Dean Scholarship from Emerson College in Boston, and will be studying broadcast journalism. Idanis Gallimore will be graduating magna cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, and will be going to the University of Miami for music performance. Ileana Jimenez, be graduating magna cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Miami-Dade Honors College for music education. Anjani Jerwar, graduating magna cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Miami-Dade Community College for music composition and music education. Allison Welch, graduating magna cum laude, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction, 100% Bright Future Scholarship to the University of Florida, will be studying biology. Florencia Ansewicz, graduating cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, with a 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Miami-Dade College. Alexis Crowley, graduating cum laude with a 75% Bright Future Scholarship, attending Florida International University with a literature major. Melanie Fernandez, graduating cum laude with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending the Honors College at Miami-Dade, and she will be studying international relations. Daniela Pedrosa, graduating cum laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction with a 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Florida International University with an advertising major. Janice Dubose, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, graduating cum laude with a 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Valencia Community College in Orlando and jazz performance as her major. Danny's gonna stay and work with me. Danny Rodriguez, graduating cum laude with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending University of Florida with a mechanical engineering degree. Janice Rubio, graduating cum laude with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Florida International University, the Honors College, for an accounting major. Brenda Apagueño, graduating with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Miami-Dade College for a physician's assistant. Janacy Beltran, graduating with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Miami-Dade College for an education major. Guadalupe Cruz, graduating with a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending St. Petersburg University in Russia for European History and Languages. Ashley Ferber will be graduating Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Miami-Dade College with a Business Administration major. Eric Gomez, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. And he is on a full ride to the University of Miami for business management. Danera Hill, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, academic scholarship to North Park University in Chicago, and will be majoring in physics and pre-med. Samantha Morlote, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Asbury College in Kentucky, and she is an English major. Stefania Pessoa, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship to Barry University, and will be doing fashion merchandising and communications. Veronica Ramirez, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending University of Miami for Political Science. Stephanie Sagaro, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Florida International University for a vocal performance major. Yvette Souza, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, will be attending Florida International University for music business. Camara Wells, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 75% Bright Future Scholarships to High Point University, and she will be majoring in biology. Leonetta Costa, and she will be attending Miami-Dade College. Enrique Alvarado. He's received a 50% Bright Future Scholarship to attend Barry University and will be majoring in International Business and Marketing. Yolanda Aviles, and will be attending Miami-Dade College. Camila Banus. She will be attending New World School of the Arts, and she's a theater major. Sammy Brooks will be attending Florida International University with a major in criminal justice. Jonathan Carreras will be attending Miami-Dade College for chiropractic medicine. That's what they want to do. Marie Carrier, Marie, should I read your card? She's getting a 75% Bright Future Scholarship. She'll be attending Miami-Dade Honors College, and she'll be an education major. Ana Cristina Cotto, she'll be attending Miami-Dade College for a theater major. Valentin Davi. Valentin will be a mechanical engineer. Paulina de Regil, she has a 4-year scholarship to Anahuac University in Mexico. Yeah. Danielle Diaz will be attending Miami-Dade College for Music Engineering. Alexander Dubon will be attending the Art Institute of Miami for Animation. Martin Escobar will be attending Miami-Dade College for Architecture. Natalia Espinal will be attending Florida International University for a psychology major. Lauren Fajardo has 100% Bright Future Scholarship to Florida International University and will be a psychology major. Lisbeth Ferreira, Miami-Dade College for a nursing degree. Gabby Frick, Miami-Dade College for Business Administration. Jesus Gallimore, he has a 75% Bright Future Scholarship, will be attending Miami-Dade College for Music Major. Amanda Gonzalez, Miami-Dade College for Architecture. Catherine Gonzalez, she will be attending Miami-Dade College for Fashion Design. Blanca Granda will be attending Miami-Dade College for a pre-med major. Merlin Grau be attending Miami-Dade College for a law. Bailey Gutman will be attending Broward Community College for a psychology major. Robert Higgins. Robert Higgins will be joining the Air Force. Guillermo Jimenez, attending Florida International University for an accounting major. Brian Lapadula, Miami-Dade College for Business Administration. Sandra Levy, Miami-Dade College for Interior Design. Gabriel Lopez, Miami-Dade College as a theater major. Bianca Marcellus, Miami-Dade College for pre-dentistry. Shazrin Martinez, Florida International University's dual program and a major in hospitality management. Marcelo Mesquita, Miami-Dade College for Graphic Design and Advertising. Diana Morales, Miami International University of Art and Design for Advertising. Matt Nunes, Miami-Dade College as a registered nurse. Mildred Petit with an academic scholarship to Barry University for social services major. Enrique Quintero will be attending Miami-Dade College for a pre-dental major. Eduardo Ramos Sanchez will be attending Miami-Dade College for teacher education. Stephen Roa. 100% Bright Future Scholarship to Santa Fe Community College, who will be studying anesthesiology. Michelle Santacoloma. She was awarded the RISE Competition Scholarship for St. Thomas University and will be majoring in communications. Alexander Sherman. Miami-Dade College for Pharmacy. Kelly Silva. She will be attending School of Visual Arts for Nylon Magazine. It's an internship in New York City. Richard Silva. Miami-Dade College and Computer Engineering major. Christy Stanton will be attending Santa Fe Community College and she will have a law major. Kristen Tarago. Miami-Dade College for Musical Theater. Britt Tunum. Miami-Dade College for Business Administration. Yeah. Danielle Yanez. Miami-Dade College for a Nursing Degree. Natalie Inigo. 100% Bright Future Scholarship to Miami-Dade Community College for Veterinarian Science.
Good afternoon. By this time, I need a wipey. The gummy bears were a little sticky. After the first row. Thank you. And Gabby Frick as well. Good afternoon, parents, family, friends, staff, and class of 2008. Once again, I welcome you and I hope you enjoyed the ceremony thus far. Before I declare you as an official graduating class, I do have some words I would like to share with you. Seniors, it is important that today you take the time to thank your parents for providing you with the love, discipline, support, and guidance that they have offered you in order to mold you into the persons that you are today. Make sure you do that before you leave. Parents, I must also thank you for having faith in Arts and Minds by allowing us to take the lead role in one of the most important endeavors in your child's life, and that is their high school education. I know that initially there were many doubts about our school, and understandably so. A new school, only 70 students, in a shopping center, some limited resources, what is a charter school? And those are just some of the questions you proposed to me. Nonetheless, you bought into the one element that the administration, board, faculty, and staff presented you with, and that is a vision to become an academic and artistic powerhouse, to integrate the arts and allow your child to become a well-rounded artist and excel in a quality educational program. This is a vision like none other in this state, and thank you for buying into that. In a time where FCAT tests and school grades have become the measuring stick for education, Arts and Minds took on a different approach. We strongly believe that by allowing our teachers to teach their respective subject areas, we can accomplish more than preparing your child for just a test. We believe that we have prepared them for life by exposing them to the classics in combination with real-world issues. We feel that we have broadened their horizons and prepared your children for their collegiate careers. The proof is in the data, and I would like to share some of it with you to reaffirm that you not only made the right decision for your child, but you made the best decision for your child. While Miami-Dade County Public Schools are graduating roughly 60% of their students, I am very proud to announce that our first graduating class has a 97.3 graduation rate. Thank you. 30% of our graduating seniors have earned the highest diploma offered by the school system, the Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. All of our graduating seniors are college bound. They have been accepted into school nationwide, including the University of Miami, Syracuse, University of Florida and Florida State, Boston University, High Point University, Asbury College, Florida International University, Florida Gulf Coast, Florida Atlantic, Central Florida, Barry, Johnson & Wales, Miami-Dade Community College, Santa Fe, and Tallahassee Community College. Arts and Minds seniors have earned over $250,000 in Bright Future scholarships and private scholarship funds. You are to be commended for that. There is one exception to our list of graduates, one student who will not be college bound, but instead he will make our nation proud and he will make Arts and Minds family proud as he enlisted in the Air Force, and that is Robert Higgins. Parents, the data speaks volume as to what has been accomplished at Arts and Minds in 4 short years. You made the best choice. Seniors, to describe this class, I would use the following words: trailblazers, trendsetters, fearless, dedicated, finally united, spirited, and the first to establish tradition. You have collectively created a sense of pride and tradition at Arts and Minds that will carry over for many years to come. No longer do people need to inquire about our school. Because of you, we've established a name for ourselves and a solid foundation to continue to build on. I thank you for that. I've had the honor of watching you grow and mature into the successful young men and women that you are today. The challenges that you have overcome have prepared you for what's ahead in your life. Rest assured that you will continue to overcome and conquer any situation that life throws your way. Just remember, keep a positive attitude. Strive to be the best you can be. Do not take no for an answer. Stand up for what's right. Stand up for what you believe in. Take risks, but ask questions. And most importantly, set your goals high. To the moon, as the commissioner expressed in his speech. Each of you possess the necessary tools for success. You have the brains, the book smart characteristics, but more importantly, you have personality and character. And that is what will set you aside from everybody else and make you triumphant individuals. Class of 2008, stay true to who you are. As you exit this venue today, know that you have done something special and that you have left your mark and have set the foundation for what is Arts and Minds. Most importantly, know that you will always have a place to call home at A&M. Congratulations, seniors. And I leave you with this quote from Henry David Thoreau. You studied him in 11th grade. I leave you with a quote from Mr. Thoreau: go confidently in the direction of your dreams and live the life that you have imagined. Congratulations. Can I ask the senior class to please rise? By the power granted in me by the state of Florida and the Miami-Dade County School Board, I now declare you graduates with all the rights and privileges thereof. Congratulations and leave your classes. At this time, I would like to ask everyone to join us, stand and join us, and join Angeline and the senior class in singing our alma mater. It is located on your program. It